Welcome to Spaces 101. This is a bit of a different video than usual. It's meant to be a guide and an explanation for how Spaces work. Spaces is a new feature for some. It's a pretty advanced feature, and we thought it was the perfect moment to take a second and explain how it works in depth. So let's start with an introduction. What are Spaces? Spaces are meant to be a distraction-free environment where you can store all the information that's related to, for instance, a specific project or information that you want to be contained into a specific place. So it's basically one more layer of organization and one more tool in your toolbox. And so let's see how it works. Now, first of all, let's see the difference between notebooks, stacks, and spaces, which are different levels of hierarchy that you can use when you are organizing your Evernote account. Notebooks are a container for notes. So notebooks are meant to be the place where notes are stored, and they are usually grouped around a specific topic. Notebooks can be shared with others. They are one of Evernote's like core building blocks since the beginning. And they are the most basic and fundamental layer of organization within the Evernote account. So while it's possible for a user to use Evernote without even knowing what stacks or spaces are, it's impossible to use Evernote without a notebook. Notebooks are fundamental. At the same time, when your account grows and you create a lot of notebooks, it's easy for your account to get cluttered, and it's a bit more difficult to stay organized and to quickly locate the information that you need. And this is where stacks and spaces come in. A stack instead is a collection of notebooks. So there cannot be a empty stack. It can only live with notebooks inside. And it's perfect, for instance, as in this example, to collect a few notebooks that are all related to the same topic, like vacation planning, bills and receipts, travel documents, recipes, all go under the life stack in this case. Another good example is I have a notebook for each of my family members for their medical documents, and I want to group all the notebooks under a health stack, for instance. When you click on a stack, it doesn't differentiate between which notes are in which notebook. They only show like a long list of notes. Last piece of information about stacks is you cannot share stacks with others. It's just an individual layer of organization that you can choose to adopt. Now, let's get to spaces. So spaces are intended as workspaces. They are perfect for specific projects. And unlike stacks, spaces are independent entities. This means that they can exist as empty spaces. Spaces can contain both notebooks and notes. Spaces are also a bit more intuitive than stacks when looking at the information that's contained in them, because you can just see the items in the all items section here. So you can see notebooks and notes, and you can see everything at a glance. In this example, we are using a space to manage all the documents that we need for a vacation. So I have travel insurance, passport information, hotel information, as well as a few notebooks for activities and flights. As you can see here, it's possible to share a space with others. In this case, the perfect example is family members. And you can pin notes to spaces, even if they are contained inside notebooks. So to summarize, this is a nice table. We also have a blog post with it. This is a nice table that tells you all you need to know about what the difference between notebooks, stacks, and spaces. Now, let's get to the practice. How do I create a space? So the first thing you need to do is you just click plus close to the spaces item in your sidebar, and you give your new space a name and a description, which is optional. In this case, I'm choosing to create a vacation space. Once you create it, the space will be empty. So if I want, I can create a note, create a notebook, add some files. In this case, what I want to do is I want to move in existing notebooks to this space that I had already created. This is a good example because oftentimes we start small with a small notebook, but then we want to start being more organized, and so we want to merge everything into a new space. So in this case, I want to add my vacation planning notebook. And here it is. So this is my vacation space and it has my vacation planning notebook inside it. If I want to do it in another way, I can navigate to my notebook. I can hit the three dots menu here and I can click move and I can choose my space. Okay, so here are my two notebooks. I also added a few notes here. I also see what's new here, so the most recently edited notes. And I see with the people with whom I have shared this space. Now, let's get to the use case for individuals. Spaces are useful both for individuals and for groups, teams, for instance. Let's address them one by one. So, individuals. Let's take a look at a few examples of how individuals can use spaces. So, life, work, and school. An example of a life use case, quote unquote, is Cleo and Damien are two parents. They have two kids, Troy and Zoe, and they use Evernote to keep track of finances, health, vacations, appointments, etc. Now, in this case, we are looking at the Zoe space, which is the space that contains all the documents related to Zoe, one of the kids. And so you see the doctor notebook, summer camp, karate, school, and there's a chart with chores. And as you can see, it's shared with two people. They also use spaces to keep track of trips. So in this case, they are going to the Bahamas. And again, they have all the information for flights, hotel, summary of the trip, activities, etc. When it comes to work instead, career coaching is a good example. So Joy is a career coach with many clients. They meet once per week, and in order, since they are many, she needs to be organized and to keep track of all the things that that she discusses with clients. And so she also does like some preparation, some work on like resumes, cover letters, and here is all the items that she works on. And then lastly, we have school. So Stephen is a college senior majoring in American literature. And here you can see all the ways he is organizing study content. In this case, you can see that the workspace is shared with a few of his classmates. This makes it easier for them to add content to it. Now let's look at a few examples for teams instead. We divided the examples into projects, knowledge base, and clients. So projects, for instance, in this case, we want to launch an app. We have all the documents for a project kickoff, the budget, the feedback from stakeholders. It's shared with the teams. Three most important notes in the space are pinned here. And then here you have all the items. There are a few notebooks divided by function mostly. And then a general note with status updates. You can also use spaces as a knowledge base. So in this case, the team uses the space as a hub for all of the information that's generally shared with people inside the team. So there are some internal processes, there are some resources for customer success, there are some documents for software developers, meeting notes are shared in this other notebook, and on top here you see the notes that are edited the latest. And again here you can see the pinned notes with the team directory, some tutorials, and the product updates. Last example is that of an agency handling and managing clients with a space. So in this case, you see a notebook for a CRM in this space, a list of deliverables, a playbook for a kickoff. It can be used as a template, for instance, or like a list of things to do for each client when you kick off new projects, and then an archive for completed projects. Okay, so how does the directory work? The directory is only available to teams. It's not available to individual users. In case you're a team, you will find the directory in your sidebar and it will look like this. You can see a list of the spaces that are available in your team. You can request access for spaces that you don't have access to. In some cases, like in this case, hiring process, the information inside it is confidential. So I need to request access and for it to be approved before I have access to it. In other cases, more generic spaces can be free to access, and so I can just join this getting started with Evernote space and I can just enter here and see all of the content. Okay, let's also take a last look at permissions and content and more. This is especially interesting to those who are admins of a team's organization on Evernote. So this is the way the admin console looks like. I can see the details of Ezra's space. It was last updated 5 minutes ago, and I can see who the members are. I can decide if I want to remove or add more. I can also see the settings for visibility. In this case, it is listed in the space directory, and people can join with view access. I can edit it. I can set that others cannot see the space, so it won't show up in the list. Others must request access, as we've seen previously, or can join. Anybody can join with view access, or edit and invite access. I can also select a space and click actions here. And in this menu, I can decide to join the space myself, add some members, remove all members, or delete the space itself. And this was it. So thank you for sticking to it. Let me know if this was helpful. Let me also know if you'd like to see this type of video for other parts of Evernote. Spaces is probably one of the most unknown ones, and so we wanted to do it. But in case you're curious about other tools in the Evernote toolbox, just let us know in the comments and we will try to make another video for those. Thank you very much.